everyone, thank you for joining me for Audrey Sana videos. I'm here today with Keaton from the Pagia Studios. He's going to be doing a yoga flow with me. So this is going to be one that is probably oriented more to men and athletes and cyclists. So because we're going to get into the hips and things like that. So anyway, let's just start in child's pose. So yeah, you can face that way. Just start in child's pose. Knees wide. And then drop your hips back in between your legs. And then let's reach our arms out a little bit and drop our forehead to the mat. You can just rock your forehead back and forth a little bit. Just getting into your position right now, getting ready to move. Take a deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth. Take another deep breath in through your nose and out through your mouth. Just blow it out. Now let's rock ourselves up into tabletop. Bring our knees closer together. Tops of your feet are flat on the mat. We're going to pull our core in so we're nice and stable. Our fingers are spread gently apart, but we're pushing into our fingertips and the palms of our hand. So then let's drop our stomach to the floor, look up, come back in to cow pose, back to the ceiling or cat pose, back to cow, up to cat. And as you come up to cat, pull your shoulders, like you're pushing yourself away from the floor and back. And you can also do this seated, like if you want to sit here, you can go back and forth as you're in a seated. This is a great thing to do if you're at your desk, you're just like at work a little bit and you're having some stress, just do a few little cat cows. Okay, so then why don't you just come back up here, and then let's tilt our head to the right and then roll our neck forward and then go to the left. Go back down, opening up your trap muscles. I know when I ride my bike, I get like for a long period of time, I get very like tight in my shoulders from that position when you're bent over. Round. You can just close your eyes right now and get into your body. Okay. So now let's come back up into the tabletop position, and we're gonna tuck our toes under. And we're just going to lift our knees up off the floor. And we're just going to be floating our knees. So now we're going to reach our right leg back. We're just going to hold it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back down. Make sure you're pulling up your core here so you're not dropping in your thing. You just want to have a very flat back. Lift your left leg up and reach it back. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back down. Lift your right arm up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right hand down. Left arm up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Back down. Left right leg out. Left hand, start reaching it out in front of you if you can. Lift your right hand. I'm sorry, left hand. Back down. Let's do the other leg. Go left leg out. Start just walking your fingertips forward, using your right arm up. Come back down. You drop down to your knees. And we're gonna push back into downward dog. So reach your hips up to the sky. Pedal out your feet a little bit. You can still be up on your toes here. A lot of people, it's very hard for them to drop their heels to the floor, so you don't have to yet. But just have a little bend in your knees as you're dropping your chest down to the floor. And then slowly you'll start to eventually drop your heels down. But right now it's fine if your feet are up. Then lift your right leg up. We're gonna open up our hip a little bit. Roll your hip around in circles. 3, and go the other way. 1, 2, 3. leg up. Be pushing into your hands here too. Open up your hip. Look under your arm, at your foot. Let's roll our knee around. One way. One, two, three. We're lubricating all of those joints. Back the other way. One, two, three. Put your foot down. Now we're gonna cat forward into high plank. We're gonna come into high plank. You're gonna be, make sure your stomach is getting pulled in, your hands and feet are pulling toward each other. You're looking just sort of softly straight at the ground, but maybe a little bit in front of you. But make sure you're pulling your core up, but then dropping your hips down a little bit. Okay, and lean forward, start coming forward. We're gonna go to the ground in a count of five. Five, four, three, two, one. Turn the ground. Come up in. Come up a little bit. Drop down. And then bring your arms out straight to the sides of you. And we're just going to push ourselves up a little bit. Leaving your feet on the ground. This is strengthening your back. So then eventually we're going to lift our hands up. Right now we're just using our fingertips to push ourselves up. Take a deep breath in through your nose and out through your mouth. And then if you can start breathing in through your nose and out through your nose, that's a good way to build heat. So then press your toes down to the mat, and we're gonna tighten up our core, lift your knees up off the ground, and we're gonna press up. And back into downward dog. Let's lift your right leg up, let's start moving. Knee in to your nose, slowly, slowly. Place your right foot down in front of you. Come into that deep lunge. Raise your arms up to the sky. Just gonna hold this for a second. Now we're gonna move. So go back and fly your arms, lean forward. One, come back up. Two, three, four. I like to move very slowly to get into my body, and this is how you build strength. Two, five. You drop your left arm to the ground and raise your right arm to the sky. So you should be feeling this right here in your hip flexor. We're just going to lower our back knee to the ground. Untuck your toe. Reach up to the sky. Let's just get into those hips this morning. Reach your hands down to the ground. Let's come up on the right side. Raise your right arm up again from this angle. Raise your arm to the back. Lift your left hand up. Do a little twist. Come back down. Hands to the ground. Now we're going to lift our, tuck our back toe. Then you're just going to slowly lift your right foot up off the ground as slow as you can, and then tuck it back. And come back into downward dog. Place your foot on the ground. Now let's lift our left foot up. Same thing, slowly come forward, slow as you can. And then place your foot on the ground. Drop down into our lunge. Raise your arms up to the sky. Hold this for a second. This is all about building strength and flexibility. So just getting into your body. Now we're going to start flying it. Lean forward, arms back. One, two, three, four. This feels so good in my hips. Five. How's it feel to you?
Hard. A little slow.
A little slow. Well, slow's good for you. Drop your right arm down to the ground. Reach up. Do you feel that in your left Hip. Yeah. Drop your knee to the ground. You're gonna come back into a little lunge. This is we're dropping into our hips and we're coming here. Yeah, you can come up and come back into it. That's good. Drop your right arm to the ground. Reach up again. Ooh. Now reach back. Okay. A little twist. Come back down to the ground. Okay, hands to the ground. Slowly tuck your right leg under. Pick your left foot up slowly. Okay, come back up. Down. Okay, now we'll go up a little faster now. Lift your right leg up. Slowly to the front. High lunge. And then, yeah, go back into warrior two. Reverse warrior. Hands to the ground. Come back. Either do a handstand or just float your back leg. Come forward plank. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Back to chaturanga. Plank. Downward dog. Lift your right foot up. Left foot up. Slowly in. Place your foot on the ground. Get your balance. High lunge. Open up. Warrior two. Come in. Get into that as much as you possibly can. So we're moving slow. So we get into every single pose. And around, float, or just put your foot on the ground. Chaturanga, upward dog, downward dog. Deep breaths. Make sure your foot up. Slowly come in. You know we're doing high lunge. We're gonna mix it up a little bit though. Warrior two. Reverse warrior. Now we're gonna go straighten our right leg and go into triangle. Forward, hands around. Come back up. Warrior two. Back to warrior one. Then we're gonna fly our back foot. So we're gonna place our hands on the ground. We're going to come up into standing splits. Then we're going to come up, tuck your back knee down. One, come back up. Two, you can have your hands on the ground if that's better for you. Two, three. Okay, come back into, place your foot on the ground behind you. Sorry. High lunge. Hands to the ground. Right foot back. Chaturanga, upward dog, back chaturanga, downward dog. Deep breaths. Lift your right, left leg up, knee into chest slowly. On the ground, rise up, high lunge, open up into warrior two, reverse warrior, come back up and we're going to do a triangle, straighten your left leg, reach out, triangle, back into warrior two, back into high lunge, hands to the ground and we're going to lift our back right leg up. Standing splits. Then we're gonna like do three tucks behind our knee. One, come up. Two. Three. Reach your right leg back into high lunge. Hands to the ground. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Back to chaturanga, plank, downward dog. Two, three breaths. forward, bend your knees, or walk or step to your hands. Halfway lift, forward fold, reach up to the sky, hands to heart center, mountain pose. Now we're gonna do some balance poses. So we've gotten a little bit warmed up. We haven't hit anything too hard yet, but we're gonna go into some balances. So now we're going to root your left foot down, pick your right foot up off the ground. And if you can, straighten it, but that's a very hard, like advanced. So I'm just gonna keep my knee bent. So then we're going to open up that leg. You can reach your left arm out, keep your hand on your knee. Then if you can slowly move your hand down to your ankle on that side, reach back, bring your left arm forward. We're gonna come into dancers on this side. Just as much as you can. Good job. So now bring your knee back. Then we're gonna put our throat, bring our foot straight forward. Get your balance. And then to the ground. Good job. Okay, so now root down in your right foot. You can have a soft bend in your knee. That's totally fine. It's probably even better. So lift your right foot up, left foot up off the ground. You can straighten it and then bend. Now right, left hand to the left knee, open up your hips. If you need to reach out, you can, just keep your balance. So now we're gonna bring this arm forward as we reach back for our back foot. Do the dancers. Good job. Come forward. And we're gonna reach our foot out again, straight out. And place it to the ground. Hands to heart center, mountain pose. Reach your arms up to the sky. Fold forward. Halfway lift. Hands to the ground. Jump back. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Back to chaturanga. Downward dog. We're gonna do that second flow we did again. Lift your right foot up. Knee to chest. Sit forward. Reach up, high lunge. Open up warrior two. Reach back. Come forward, warrior two. Straighten that right leg, triangle. Back to warrior two. Reach up, high lunge. Reach hands to the ground. We're gonna do standing splits on this side again. Bring your knee down. We're gonna do this pistol squats. One, or Shiva squats. Two, then we're gonna do pistol from here. Three, we do five this time. Four, five, come up. Okay, so now tilt your body up and bring that knee forward. And then we're gonna come down. Good job. So you can see, yeah, that's what happens most of the time. So just come on down to your butt. We're going to bring that foot that's out just underneath and bring your right foot over the top. We're just gonna twist. Reach up with your left hand, twist. So I hope you're feeling, what I'm feeling is like I'm getting a lot going on in my glutes on the sides, and that's what I really need today. A lot of that opening, because when you're a cyclist or athlete, or you do a lot of leg day stuff, you need to open up those muscles. Even if you're sore from the day before, it's always good to have just a little bit of movement, just so you don't stiffen up. Because I feel like you stiffen up if you have worked out hard and then you don't do anything the next day. It can make you very stiff. Okay, come back. Lay that, left foot goes out, right foot goes back. And we're gonna try our pistol squat to stand up. And if this is not your thing, go ahead and just bring both your feet in and you can lean forward and stand up from there. But let's just give it a try. And sometimes I would even say grab your toe. It helps a little bit. Try to get your stomach in. So you're already leaning forward, you're helping yourself. You can use your right hand to balance, my right hand here on the mat to like hold me. And I'm gonna stand up. Sit to the ground. Good job. Keaton said not to make this too hard, and I was like, I can't help myself, I guess. Is it hard? Sorry. Okay, raise your arms up to the sky. Fold forward. Half lift. Place your hands on the ground, jump or step back. Chaturanga. Upward dog. Down dog. We're gonna do this left side. Take three breaths though first. We take three breaths in down dog. In through the nose and out through the nose. Okay, lift your left leg up. Slowly come in, bring it in. Place your foot down. High lunge. Get into it deeply. Bend that knee, 45 degree angle. Open up, warrior two. Reverse warrior. Come up and straighten that front leg. Come out into triangle. Come back into warrior two. High lunge. Hands to the floor, standing splits. Okay, now come back and do a five cheetah squats. Knee behind your. You can have your hands on the ground if that's better for you. Two. Three. Four. Five. Okay, now I'm going to try the pistol squat on this side and see what happens. Come up. Foot out. If you need to grab your toe, grab your toe. Or if you need to just have your knee bent, that's fine too. Whatever you can do to get here. So just come down. Good job. Did it. Okay, so now grab this foot. The right leg out is going to go under the left. Left leg goes over that knee. You can see what's going on here. Right arm up and twist. Woo! Feels good though, doesn't it? Release. Back to your pistol squat. So you're going to stretch your right leg out front. Use your left hand behind you on the ground if you want. To get yourself just up to here at least. And then stand up. There you go. Place your foot on the ground slowly. It's all about finding the control in your body. And these little movements and big movements make you extra strong. It gives you that strength that you're going to need as you age. So we all want to stay young and at least have our body think that we're young. Not necessarily our minds, but our bodies. Or our minds too. We want our minds to stay fresh, but and this helps that too. Okay. Reach your arms up to the sky. Fold forward. Halfway lift. Place your hands on the ground. Step or jump back. I like to jump. Upward dog. Back to chaturanga. Plank. Downward dog. Do you want to do that one more time? Or are we gonna relax?
Whatever.
In pigeon, or are you gonna do one more flow?
One more
flow. Let's do a little core. So let's do a little core. So lift your. I'm gonna start with my left, so you can see what I'm doing. Usually I start with my right, but I'll start with my left. Lift your left leg up. Bring your knee to your right elbow, and then we're going to roll over onto the knife edge of our back foot that's still up. We're going to extend that leg out, reach your arm up, and you can have this on the floor, it's fine too, but we want to get a nice arch going through here. So we're going to lift that foot up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, knee in. Hand back to the ground. Knee to elbow. Come up. Place your foot on the ground. Now you're the other side. Lift your right foot up. Right foot to left elbow. Roll around onto the flat part of your foot. Come up. Foot to the ground. 1, 2, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Knee in, hand back down, touch that elbow again, come back up, good to the ground. Now let's do some frog jumps while we're here. So basically, we're going to just jump and try to tap our feet. You don't have to even come, just, you don't even have to come that much high on your hands. Do as many as you want. Just play around. That's getting you ready for a little bit of handstand. Okay, so let's come down into squat pose. Legs wide open. Okay, sit your booty to the floor. And we're gonna come into boat. Legs up, arms out. You can get your legs straight, Not, no worries. Okay, low boat. High boat. 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 Oh, I'm getting tired, okay. A little bit. All right, that's enough for that one. Okay, now lay on your back. We're going to bring our heels together and we're gonna just like rock our hips up and put your hands behind your head. You should start feeling this about three or four. I do. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, come down, baby. We're not done with core. We're going to do some more core. Sorry. Okay, so now we're going to stretch one leg up, your left leg or right leg up to the sky. It's whatever you want to do. You take our hands, we're going to make them into a pointing hands together. We're going to come up and get our little side. One, two, three, four, five, six. Scissor your legs together. Seven, eight, nine, 10. Just 10. Okay, let's see the other side. Okay, ready? One, two, three. Let's do your legs together. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Okay, I do feel that. Woo! Come in, happy baby. Let's do one leg happy baby. So drop your left foot to the ground and just open up that leg if you can. Keep it bent if you need to keep it, and open it up. Come back. Go to the other side. Open it up. Come back. Okay, so now cross your legs. We're going to roll up. We're going to come back to hands and knees. So if you can, what I like to do is I like jump. It's up to you if you just want to step too. Get yourself some momentum. That was kind of a weird landing. I'm keeping to the right. We're done. Now we're done. Lift your right leg up.
I thought you said hands and knees.
Yeah, I know. You know how it is. You know how it is on a Saturday morning. Your brain's only half working. Lift your right leg up in case we're going to pigeon pose. You thought I was going to make you do some work. Nope. We're done. I can do it some more, but I have the feeling he's done. Okay, so now come up and try to keep your back foot straight and pull forward. Whew. This is
like, I think, one of my favorite poses. I don't know.
I mean, you can only be in it for so long because then it begins to start to get uncomfortable. But when I first get into this, and I love like triangle too. I don't know what it is. Something about your hips or your side body. My least favorite is chair. As you can tell, I did no chairs. But they say you're supposed to do the ones you don't like, but I feel like I get a lot of chair. If you have someone with you that's doing this class with you, have them come over. One of you take turns and just press on the other one's hips here gently. That's a really nice thing. And then pull up, you can just like pull up their body a little bit on the side to give them some little extra stretch. Sometimes I also like just like pound on this muscle to release it a little bit. I like that. Does that feel good?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. When you're ready, come out of that. So we're gonna lift up our knee and then slowly come back. You're gonna open up that hip and you can flip into a wild thing if you want to. So just get a little back opening up. And then when you come back out of wild thing, go slow. Like try to keep your body as slow as possible getting back. A little bit of a challenge. It's fun. Lift your left leg up. Come into the pigeon on that side. Left foot to right wrist. If you can get this leg straight, that's fine. If not, I can't. I just kind of like bend it in. Keaton has it more straight. Just gonna stand, sit up straight, and fall, roll forward. Place your forehead on the ground, on your hands, anywhere that's comfortable. And just feel into this pose. I'm gonna go stretch them again. So you guys can stay in it now, or if you have someone with you that can help you out, just press into that.
Press down.
Press down here. Yeah. Okay, so I'm pressing down on his, so his left leg bent headed, but he wants me to press on his right. So just listen to the person that you're with and see what they like. And if they say it's too much, just. And you can feel if it's too much too, like sometimes people won't tell you, but their body will tense up. That's a good way to know. Okay. Stand up three, stand a few more breaths, like three more maybe, two or three. Feels good. Reach it back, open up that hip, and come into wild thing. Slowly as you can. Is this the challenge? Just go slow and open. You never want to flop into anything. Bring the knee up, just go as slow as you can. Yep, good job. Slow. Good job. Cool. Jump on. Okay. So now we're going to jump through our hands or walk through. Legs out straight. Get your back as straight as possible. Reach up and fold forward of your legs. You can have your knees bent here if that's better for you, or you don't have to come down as far as I do. If you just want to be here, that's fine. And have your knees bent. Whatever you can do. It's a slow progression. Okay, come up. Let's take our right foot inside of our left leg. We're gonna reach up with our right arm and tilt over. And if you can reach that foot, great. I have to like make my foot straight because I have an ankle problem, but then I can get into it a little bit easier. The other side. Left leg in, right leg out. I'm gonna grab my left leg with my right hand. Reach up. Get some nice side body stretches going. Arms, legs spread wide, hands open, receiving. Close your eyes. Shavasana. As you lay here, I want you to think about what you want in life, like what you want to make for your life and how you want to live it. Wanting to be good to people and nice and helpful, but also taking care of yourself. And not just giving everything you have to everyone. You need to make sure you save enough for yourself so you don't turn into someone that people feel guilty for being around. You know, women have a way sometimes of just, and maybe men, turning themselves into a martyr because they give too much. You just have to appreciate everything you have in life. And with appreciation, you get even more. Gratitude, acceptance, accepting your body as it is, but making it strong and healthy and giving it good nutrients and healthy food, not polluting yourself, not polluting your mind, trying to keep as much of a positive outlook as you can on life, because sometimes when there's negative things that happen, they happen for a reason. To help us find the positive. There's no yin without yang, you know? So, anyway, close your eyes and lay there, relax. If you're ready, start moving your feet and hands around. If not, you can stay there as long as you'd like. Just lay there and sink into yourself. Let's reach your arms overhead. Tilt your hips back and forth like you just woke up in the morning. I have to arch my back. Bringing some space into my body. Let's roll over to our right side. And slowly come up into seated pose. eyes closed if you can. You can open them. Hands to heart center. Thank you all for joining us. We really appreciate everything. And want you to check out our audriosana.live/workouts if you'd like to learn more. Thank you so much. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you for watching our video. We have so many more to offer you. So, to see our full catalog with our lovely trainers and Audrey and Asana, please go to www.audriasana.com. There you'll find everything under the sun: yoga, workouts, our video podcasts, and so much more. I hope to meet you there. Ciao.